Number 32. Even when the head is held erect, as in figure 9.40, its center of mass is not directly over the principal point of support, the atlanto-occipital joint. The muscles at the back of the neck should therefore exert a force to keep the head erect. That is why your head falls forward when you fall asleep in class, or when you repeatedly bash your head into the desk because it's more fun than sitting through the boring lecture. Letter A. Calculate the force exerted by these muscles using the information in the figure. So here's the figure, and I basically redrew it over here a little larger. All right, we have three forces in the problem. Okay, we have the force that the muscles are producing in order to balance the weight of the head, which would naturally fall forward if you fell asleep. And then there's also a balancing, there is then a force that will balance these two negative forces, and that's going to be the force that is being experienced at the atlanto-occipital joint. Now, in order to find the force that the muscles are producing, remember this force will counteract the weight force, and more specifically, the torque that this force produces will counteract the torque that this weight produces. Okay. Now the head is going to be held stationary, and therefore the sum of the torques in this problem will equal zero. I don't know what this is. It's supposed to be a sum, but it doesn't look like it at all. Neither does that. And that looks like an E, so we'll just leave it alone. Now, let's then detail how many torques are there, by the way, in the problem. If you said three, it would be incorrect. There's two torques, one torque here, one torque here. Why? Why doesn't this produce a torque? Well, because the force is acting exactly at the axis of rotation. What's the lever arm if the force is acting exactly at that axis of rotation? Well, the lever arm is zero. There is no lever arm. And therefore, according to this formula, if R is zero, what happens to the whole right side? It goes to zero. And if the right side is zero and that's equal to torque, then torque is zero. Man, this coffee's great. Okay, so now let's start plugging in these torques, all right? So we have the torque being produced, let's say, by the muscle. If you pretend, right, here's the axis of rotation, this force is applied, it's going to rotate the bar counterclockwise, and therefore it's going to be a positive torque. The weight here would act in the exact opposite direction. It would produce a clockwise rotation, therefore that torque is going to be negative. So let's leave that as the negative torque of the weight, and that's all equal to zero. Therefore, the torque of the muscles are producing should balance the torque that the weight is producing, and that's exactly what we said before. Now, I realize that all of these lever arms are 90 degrees relative to the forces, so therefore, I don't need the sine of theta because the theta in this problem is 90. Sine of 90 is 1. That whole thing just cancels, blah, blah, blah. And I should really drink espresso more often. And now here we are now going to plug in these values, okay? So here we have now the lever arm for the muscle multiplied then by the force the muscle is producing is then equal to the lever arm for the weight of the head multiplied by then the force of the weight, which that's kind of redundant, right? That's just the weight of the head. Now solving for the force that the muscles have to produce, it would be F sub M is equal to RW FW all over RM. All right, and this is the formula. So now all we have to do is plug in the values. So let's do that over here on the left-hand side. So here we have R sub W is now the lever arm, the lever arm of the weight. So that's going to be 0.025 multiplied by the weight of that head, which is 50 newtons. That's all divided then by the lever arm for the muscle. So 0.050. Plugging this all in, let's plug it into the calculator. And 0.025 times 50 divided by 0.05. And what do we get? We get a value of 25. So 25 newtons. Now, interesting, right? Notice the weight here is 50 newtons, but we are then supplying a force of 25 newtons to counteract this particular torque. Well, it's exactly half. Well, why is that the case? Remember, the relationship between lever arms and torques are inversely related. Okay, so if this lever arm is essentially 2.5 centimeters, and this lever arm is 5 centimeters. Since this lever arm is double this lever arm, then the force that's necessary to counteract the torque will be half of this force. And that's exactly what we find here. So that all makes sense. So this is letter A. Let's move on now to letter B. So the letter B now says, what is the force exerted by the pivot on the head? Okay, so that is now F sub J. Again, we cannot look at this through a torque perspective because this doesn't produce a torque, therefore we just cancel. So now we have to think about this as the sum of all the forces is equal to zero. Why is that the case? Well, because it's in equilibrium and it's in static equilibrium. So now here we have three forces, positive, and these are both negative. All right, why? Because of their directions. So here we have F sub J minus F sub M minus W is all equal to zero. Reorganizing this would be F sub J is equal to F sub M plus W. Plugging in the values, right? We just found the force of the muscle is going to be 25 newtons. The weight is then going to be 50 newtons. And when we add these two together, the total is then 75. So this is the force. All right, guys, thanks for tuning in. Please remember to subscribe. Definitely helps us out tremendously. Hit that like button if it helped you. Tell your friends and classmates. We won't mind. All right? Thank you so much. Take care.